Today, an estimated 345 million people are facing high levels of food insecurity. Of these staggering numbers, 40 million people are at the brink of famine and starvation. We stand at a critical crossroads. Without major interventions, this current global food crisis will further aggravate, driving us even further away from the goal of eradicating hunger by 2030. My name is Ingrid de Zwarte and I'm an assistant professor of economic and environmental history at Wageningen University. My research focuses on the role of food and famine in modern warfare and is driven by a passionate interest in the dynamics between hunger and conflict. Professionally as well as personally, I'm deeply concerned about the fact that hunger is still being used as a weapon of warfare today. For example, in sieges, economic blockades, scorched earth tactics, but also, for example, by the use of the threat of famine or promise of food for propaganda purposes. This monument, manna, symbolizes the Swedish white bread that was eaten in the Netherlands during the Dutch hunger winter of 1944-1945. And it symbolizes the daily struggle to survive during the Second World War. But I think in a broader sense, it's also a reminder that famines are part of a shared past and that we have a duty to actively engage in preventing new hunger crises from happening. In the second half of the 20th century, we achieved the technical capacity to eradicate famine. Yet paradoxically, the 20th century also witnessed some of the most lethal famines in history. And the reason for all of that was mostly politics, government failure, totalitarian regimes and warfare. So what can we learn from the history of famine for the future of famine? I would say that history tells us that famines are not inevitable. Famines today are not just the result of rapid population growth, of climate shocks or natural disasters. Famines are entirely man-made. But this also means that we have the power to prevent them from happening. Unfortunately, there are no simple solutions to eradicate famine. Moving into the future, I would say that pathway solutions should be aimed at creating resilient societies and strong global institutions to ensure equal access to food for everyone and to prevent, prohibit, and hold to account starvation tactics. Because without urgently needed political action, it will be difficult for us to make famine history.